We're here in Vegas, Extreme Couture again, with Jay Heron, Lars Sohn, at the scene at the Bellator tournament that you won at 170. But for you hardcore fans, the diehard fans, you've seen Jay around for a long time. IFL, Affliction, is for the UFC, you fought Strikeforce, lastly seen in Bellator. Where else have you fought? Is that it?
Ring of Combat in New Jersey. I never fought overseas yet, so I've been over there to Japan, but I didn't fight there. But I fought every major promotion in America, you know, IFC too back in the day. You know, I mean, but don't get it twisted, I'm not a journeyman. A journeyman is somebody they bring in that fights everywhere that loses. My record speaks for itself, I win, so.
His record definitely speaks for itself, 23-4, and the men that he's for include GSP. He was supposed to have a title fight against Nick Diaz for Strikeforce. That didn't happen, unfortunately. Diaz tested positive for cannabis.
Chiba.
The Reaper.
He likes to do his thing.
And unfortunately, that didn't happen. And then Bellator, you won the tournament. Next for you is the title fight for the 170 title at Bellator.
Yeah, I'm excited, man. You know, the tournament was a grind. It wasn't really, I didn't really have time to prepare for the next fight after you win the first fight because it's so quick turnaround. You know, but it, you know what I mean? In this point in my career, I feel I needed something like that. I had a long layoff. It was about a year and change layoff, about just around a year. You know, I was, you know what I mean? I was ready to go, you know, the whole time. I took advantage of my downtime. I trained all the time. You know, I learned a lot of new things. A lot of times in your professional career, you don't get that chance to take a step back and push that reset button, get your skills up, because MMA is a learning curve. Every day is something new to learn. You know, you take time off, you're behind. So, took total advantage of that time off, and I was ready. Once I made this decision to go to Bellator, I was ready, you know, I got in there, I did my thing, and for me, that's what it's about right now, fighting for titles, being the best I could be, winning these, stacking up these wins, you know, getting my name up there and being the best.
And for people that haven't, you know, there's more mainstream fans now that watch UFC, might not have heard your name, and as you said, you're definitely not a journeyman, and you've been up against the best, you've been supposed to fight for some major titles, your record speaks for itself. You come from a pedigree wrestling background, ranked number 3 in the country back before college, correct? A Greco-Roman, in college, Greco-Roman, freestyle.
Yeah.
And you've had a couple of setbacks, not in your own fighting career, but the politics behind the scene, the contracts, the organizations, the promotions. And I think there's very few people, fighters themselves, that would not consider you top 5, at least top 10 in the world, and a threat to anyone up there. You're fighting for the title in November. That's obviously your next focus. What's after that fight for you?
Well, I mean, first, you know what I mean? First and foremost, I believe everything in my career happens for a reason. You know, I think God just puts all these obstacles in front of me, inside, outside the cage, that, you know, he wants me to, you know, get through before I get to a certain place I want to be. So I have no problem with that. I learned to embrace all the controversy, the contract stuff, the outside stuff, embrace it all, and just know it makes me the man who I am right now. It makes me train that much harder because it makes me strong-minded and everything else. So, you know, I'm blessed right now. I won the tournament. I did what I could do. I got a world title fight. I got 8 weeks, 10 weeks prepare specifically for this fight, which is great. I didn't have that chance in Bellator. You know, now you get to see what I'm really about. I'm gonna showcase more skills. I'm gonna get out there and put a show on for the fans. I'm gonna do whatever I have to do to win this fight, and, you know, we'll see what's next after that. I mean, I'm still with Bellator, you know, hopefully bigger and better things. You know, hopefully bigger and better fights.
your opponent. Tell us about him. What do you know of him, about him?
He's a wrestler, you know, pretty much. I mean, that's what he does. You know, he's a real boring fighter, you know, but it's my job to get out there and make an exciting fight and do my job and get out there and try to take his head off with some leather.
And you can wrestle yourself,
I can wrestle myself, because a lot of people forget, you know, that's my background. Wrestling since I was 13 years old, I've been on the top level wrestling, and I have no problem with my wrestling. You know, my wrestling is just as good as anybody's in this game. I train just as hard as any man in the sport. You know, I've learned to train smarter, not harder now, and I'm always implementing new stuff into my game and into my camp. I got a great team, Extreme Couture, I think we're the best in the world, best gym in the world. You know, our numbers speak for itself. You know, by all means, I'm not cocky. A lot of people say I'm cocky. It's not cocky, it's confident. I know what I have to do in the gym. I do what I do. A lot of people don't, you know, they're scared of training hard. They're scared of hard fights. I'm not. I'm confident because I train hard. I train with the best in the world.
You definitely do. You have a decent camp up here with guys around your way. You got Martin Kampmann. You got My Power Just For. You got a bunch of guys around your weight, even slightly heavier as well. Extreme Couture is one of the, we've spoken about this before, one of the nicest MMA facilities, not just in America, but in the world. So it's definitely a great place to prepare for, right?
Not only nice facility, nice place in the world, great fighters, everybody's attitude's in check, you know what I mean? Guys are all humble because there's all great fighters here. You know, if you have an ego coming in here, you know what I mean? It's gonna be a tough day in the gym. So, you know, you're gonna have bad days in here when you have great guys. You know, there's guys, you know, I have fits with just because we've been training together so long. We know each other's every move, you know, but we still, it's iron sharpens iron. We're getting each other better all the time. You know, he's doing something good. That means I'm doing something good, you know? So I'm blessed. I'm great where I'm at. I'm also, I step outside my box. You know, I went to LA for a few weeks. I trained out there, trained at a couple different gyms, you know, just to keep my stuff, you know, everything fresh. You know, you got to see different looks. And, you know, I always keep my glass half empty. I'm always trying to learn.
That's true. When you were down in LA, we had a lot of guys that were around there going, Jay Hero, and all fighters, even if the mainstream fans might not know your name, a lot of guys do, but fighters definitely do. So when you were down there, a lot of guys were excited to get a chance to train with you and you know, see how they measured up to someone who's been in the game for a long time, who's been up against the best, been a champion. Now, when it comes to ego, you're fighting, like you said, a wrestler, and you do come from a wrestling background. Do you feel the urge, the need to show him that, yeah, I can out-wrestle you, I can do what I want in the cage, or do you leave your ego outside and can you stick to a game plan to do what you have to do in order to win?
I always stick to my game plan. I never go in with an ego, big head. I'm going confident. You know, there's a big difference. You know, I know if I prepare right in the gym, I know I could beat anybody in the world on it, you know what I mean, on a good day. So, I mean, you know, if I'm healthy, I'm healthy right now, and when I'm healthy in the fight, I know I did my job in the gym. So I'm being smart. I'm not going to go out and do what he does best. You know, I know if he's trying to overwhelm me with his wrestling, I know my wrestling is just as good. You know, so, you know, I'm a way more well-rounded fighter. By all means, I'm not looking past this guy. This guy is real tough. He's undefeated. You know, he's coming from Olympic background in wrestling. I mean, you know, he's on the top level wrestling. I'm not looking past him. I feel I'm the better fighter, though. So that's what I'm trying to go out and do, and show my well-roundedness and be a better fighter.
Right. And you're not 20 anymore.
You're not 20 anymore.
It was your birthday a couple of weeks ago, and he did turn 45. But you've been working a little bit outside of the fight game. Obviously, it's going to be a future after the fight career as well. You've been in a couple of movies doing some stunts. Yeah, any movies that guys can see you in?
Yeah, there's a movie, Man on the Ledge, coming out with Sam Worthington, the guy from Avatar. Did a little scene with him in a jail scene. Go check that movie out. It's not out yet. Been in Law and Order a bunch of times. Brooklyn's Finest, the movie I've been in. I've been in a few movies. I'm blessed, you know what I mean? But, you know, that's still, my main focus is still on my fighting.
Of course,
you know, this is something else. You know, it still gives me the excitement, like a fighting a little bit, not as much, but it's something else I can look forward to when my career starts slowing down a little bit. Right now, I feel I'm in my prime. I'm in the best shape of my life. mentally, I'm the strongest that I've ever been. I'm learning, I feel great, I feel, you know what I mean? I feel like I'm 21, you know? So I take care of my body as, you know, as much as I can. I've trained around Randy Couture, 47. By all means, do I feel like I'm Randy Couture, that I can fight till I'm 47, 50? No, but I see what he does with his lifestyle, inside and outside the cage, how he preserves his body, his outtake on life and going about his training. So that's what I'm around. We started this gym together. You know, Randy said he's opening the gym up. I was one of the first guys here. So I've been around this guy 6-7 years. I know how to train and how to keep my body right. Another guy I look up to is Bernard Hopkins. You know, a guy that's 40, 46, you know what I mean? Still winning world titles. Age is nothing but a number. You know, you think you're old, you'll be old.
I agree.
You think you're young, you're training every day, you still love what you do, you're getting up, you still got pep in your step, you got it, you know? So I kind of live my life like that. People ask me, how long can you do it for? I don't put a date on it. I wake up every day, I'm smiling, I still love to go train and mix it up with the guys, I'm gonna still fight, you know? The day I feel like, I'm not into it, I don't have that drive anymore to do it, that's when I'm gonna slow down, because that's when, you know, you kind of ruin you get hurt out there. It's a rough business.
Dangerous, right?
Yeah, dangerous. So, you know, I still love to do this. I still feel I'm in top form. I still feel I can put on great fights. So I'm here. I still don't feel fulfilled. Like, you know, I've done a couple things in my career. Nothing big, but I feel I've won the world title, IFL, won the Bellator tournament, but I still don't feel fulfilled. I want to go on bigger, better things. I want to win bigger fights, and it's a matter of time.
On top of the movies, the stunts, the fighting, we also had a chance to work together with MMA Athletics with Jay Glazer down in Los Angeles with some of the NFL players. Yeah. Those are some big boys.
Yeah, it's great, man. I'm feel with MMA Athletics, Jay Glazer, Randy Couture, they put together a system that's, you know, it's great for any professional athlete out there that helps all other different sports. You know, football is the leading organization outside of MMA that they deal with, and you know, it's great. The results are incredible. You know, they're working with guys like Patrick Willis, Mercedes Lewis, Sean Merriman, Chris Long, to name a few. There's so many, but you know, you see it in their game. Yeah, it's great, man. I'm happy to be a part of it. I actually trained the Rams for a few weeks. Chris Long, real great guy. I trained Patrick Willis, Sean Merriman, you know, all good guys, man. You know, at first they were real stiff and they really, you know what I mean? They kind of had the big eyes like, are you serious? Is this going to help me? And once they started, you know, learning it and really catching on to it, their confidence went out the roof. You know, Mercedes Lewis, actually, you know, he's great kicks, you know. These guys are way better athletes now from, you know, just opening up their mind and training like a fighter.
It's funny, we were saying when we were watching Mercedes Lewis, NFL, I think he might have a future in mixed martial arts after he's done with his NFL career.
Yeah, you never know.
Good punches, good kicks, great athlete. All these guys are big and strong, but he was really showing some athleticism. So.
Yeah, it was great.
Jay Heron, what's the date? November?
November right now, no date set in stone, but look for me, November world title fight. Coming with a vengeance, man. I'm coming to get my belt.
If you want to follow Jay, you can also go to his Twitter and his website, jayheron.com.
At Jay Heron on Twitter, jayheron.com, my website, Facebook, wherever, man. Extreme Couture, send me something. I'll sign it. I'll mail it back to you. See you at the gym. If you see me, I'm a cool guy. Come up to me. I love my fans, my haters. I love y'all too. You give me motivation.
Let me give you a cell phone number too.
Nah. Okay. Are we done?
We're done.
Ah, you fucking. He's a chameleon, man. I love this guy, man. Yo, first day I met him, I liked him, you know. And I'm from New York. We don't like a lot of people. We kind of smell bullshit, but guy's real cool, man. He's been around the world, man. Go after your dreams, man. He fucking left his country when he... I'm cursing. I can curse on it? Yeah, he left his country when he was a kid to follow his dreams, man. some of you guys out there hating, you should follow his path.